Howdy, gang. Welcome to another edition of Caucasian Critic. It is me, yours truly, the titular Caucasian Critic. Caucasian Critic, the first billionaire podcaster, the Daniel Plainview of podcasting, the Caucasian Copperhead, White Sinat, the corn-fed white boy. It's me, Dalton Pruitt, and this is the Caucasian Critic, the song reaction program only on the Billionaire Podcast Network. Ka-ching, bing, 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 dee, 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 fill her up. This is the show where I listen to a song I have never heard before and offer my honest and genuine reaction to my first time listening to the song. Been doing this a while, and it's been an incredible experience, and it's been something it's been joyful sharing with you, the audience, and I couldn't do it without you. You know, you folks send me recommendations all the time for songs that are just completely off my radar, stuff I would never think to even look for. And so it means a lot that you folks, you know, listen to the show, watch it, and engage with it in this way. It's a sort of a symbiotic relationship that we have, one that benefits me because I get to discover new music, and one that creates the undying bond between audience member and YouTuber. And so for today, this is interesting because somebody reached out and said, you know, the last few episodes I've done, you know, I've gone pretty old school with the recommendations that I've been given and the songs I've reacted to, and somebody wanted me to do something a little more current, and they recommended this. I have no idea what this is. This is completely off my mind. I've never heard of this group. I've never caught any sort of wind, hide nor hair of what this is on the radio, on TV, anywhere. And I'm nervous, I'm scared, but I'm excited to listen to this. Somebody sent me a group I need to check out. This is a hip-hop group called Death Grips, and the song that was sent, that was recommended to me by one of the fans of the show, is a song from, looks like it's an album they put out in, 2012 maybe, is when this album came out. It's an album called The Money Store, and the song is called Hustle Bones by Death Grips, and that's from their album The Money Store. Looking at the cover of the album, it is frightening what I'm looking at. For those of you who are wondering, or you know, you can't see what I see, but it's a gentleman, it's a sort of a, I guess I would say this is an anime style drawing featuring a gentleman wearing a leather dog mask with the words Death Grips carved into his chest, and he seems to also be wearing a leather dog mask with the words Death Grips carved into his chest. There's a chain attached to the collar he's wearing that goes to a handcuff cuffed to the wrist of a rather grungy, crusty looking woman smoking a cigarette and wearing a leather daddy hat. And she's also got on what looks to be a tattered denim skirt, leather belt, and a sort of makeshift, I don't know what this is, fanny pack made out of like a cloth of some, I don't know what that is. And then attached to the belt is looks like there's a wallet chain that goes down, and her keys are attached to the chain. And yeah, she's got the little poochy belly, and it looks like a happy trail, some body hair, some leg hair, smoking a cigarette, and walking this man on a chain, the gentleman wearing a leather dog mask on a chain, and he seems to be holding a bag of groceries. It's a rather minimalist style for the artwork, but also very unsettling. And the person who sent me this said this is a hip hop music track, but I've never seen a hip hop album in my, I mean, my experience with hip hop music is very limited. But yeah, I've never seen an album with a cover like this, in that genre. I've never seen anything like this. This is very spooky. But anyway, let's not. Without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the song. This is Hustle Bones by the band Death Grips.
Give a fuck what you heard, yeah, fuck what you heard, for this real shit, get your whole clip to the top. What? But you don't hear me though. Run up into the depth, that grip my steez is falling out. The control what you know about violence. Hustle bones coming out my mouth. Hustle bones coming out my. Hustle bones coming out my mouth. Hustle bones coming out my. Coming out my mouth. Hustle bones coming out my. Hustle bones coming out my mouth. Hustle bones coming out my. Coming out my man. Down, looking shot, never not strapped. With a Glock, Glock, run it back. That knock a cop off, unconscious. Marked off, cocktail is out, bomb a snip. That line of chalk, round, round the clock. Too many more drop to count the steel. Stuck on the fence, how does it feel? It don't make sense, nothing is that rip, you will know what trick I'm not doing. And know me, never know me, never will know sin. You lay on the fade out, so I'll cut the door ahead and run. Hustle bones coming out my man. Hustle bones coming out my. Hustle bones coming out my mouth. Hustle bones coming out my. Coming out my mouth. Hustle bones coming out my. Hustle bones coming out my mouth. Hustle bones coming out my. Coming out my mouth. Check in with the blast, blast, ain't no breath. He's a fucking with a flame. That X gun, hard to the bone, dog mix. But his own master, the first fall beyond. Beyond the line, never crossed by them books. Give us up while I ride that fuck. Got the strength up into the sun. Like no hands, make a dust. More like man, we get no.
What is this? What is this? I don't understand what this is. It's this is I feel like I'm being assaulted right now. This is like the audio equivalent of taking 15 Benadryl. This is insane. And it's not that it's my feelings so far, we're about halfway through the song. My feelings on this so far are very complicated because this is the most unsettling, aggressive thing I've ever heard. And it's but it's also there's also something about it that I can tell, like, it's not like bad technically and musically, if that makes any sense. Like, I can tell that there's like a lot of work and care that went into this. There's a lot of like high level musical proficiency happening in this song, but this is like this feels like I'm being shot with a thousand arrows. This feels like I'm being marched upon by the army of a vast empire. This is insane. Like, I feel like I'm getting my ass kicked in an alley. Like, I feel like I'm being stabbed by a broken bottle covered in piss, sonically, as it were. This is one of the most bizarre, aggressive, just like discombobulating things I've ever heard. And it, like, I'm not trying to be cynical or necessarily like criticize this in any negative way. I'm saying that I feel very vulnerable right now after listening to this. I feel as though I've been engaged in a sort of audio fisticuffs listening to this song. And there's something going on here. So in terms of vocals and lyrics, he's got a very gruff voice. It sounds like he's got that sort of like Tom Waits quality where it sounds like he's been eating rusty nails. And it's a very almost like staccato method with which he raps. The last video I did was for A Tribe Called Quest, and those fellows rapped with a very like smooth, laid back flow. And this feels like he's rapping. It like the equivalent would be like getting shanked in prison is what it sounds like, what this sounds like when he raps. It's very like violent sound, like what he's doing, this sharp, just stark method with which he approaches rapping. But something I'm noticing is the percussion on this is interesting. Who are these guys? Forgive me. I'm going to play the song. I'm going to finish the song, but I want to know who's in this band. So I don't know anything about this group, but I like I do like what's happening on the percussion. That's interesting. I'm picking up on something very, alluring with the percussion on this. And whoa, wait, hold on. So the drums on the wait a second. So the drums on this album, the drummer for this group is Zach Hill. That's crazy. I didn't know that. So Zach, for those of you that don't know, Zach Hill is the drummer for a noise rock band from, I believe, Southern California, a noise rock band called Hella, which consists of just Zach Hill on drums, and I forget the guy's name, but the guy on guitar. And they've put out some incredible records. Hold Your Horses. What's the other one? There's No 666 in Outer Space. I can't remember the names of all their albums at the moment, but they've done some wild stuff. Hella, I love that group. And Zach Hill has also done some drumming for there is an Omar Rodriguez Lopez. It's El Grupo Nuevo de Omar Rodriguez Lopez, and I think it's called it's an album called Mantra Hiroshima. It's an instrumental album featuring Omar Rodriguez Lopez on guitar and Zach Hill on drums, and I believe he was also the drummer on the sort of a secret Mars Volta album that was El Grupo Nuevo de Omar Rodriguez Lopez. It was an album called Kryptonesia, which featured most of who was in the Mars Volta at that time. And then, yeah, I think it was Zach Hill on drums. He's been everywhere. He's one of my favorite drummers. I had no idea that he was a part of this band. And it's, I guess that kind of makes sense, because his musicianship on the other stuff I've heard him do is always very, like, very fast, very aggressive. It feels like he's just, you know, performing an exorcism on the drum set when he drums. It's crazy what he does. And so whoever this guy is that's rapping, let me see, what's his name? A fellow by the name of MC Ride. So yeah, that whatever this team up is, this is interesting. The combination of these two guys, Zach Hill teaming up with a rapper, because it's creating this sort of like hip hop audio equivalent of like getting mugged. You know, that's what it feels like. I'm getting violently beaten listening to this. But you know, but there's, it's not like, yeah, it's interesting because it's not musically, it's not bad. It's just such a jarring thing to listen to. But I'm rambling. Let's get back. Let's finish listening to the song. Here we go. This is the rest of Hustle Bones, and go. No shit, I hit it till it drip with the blood and the blood. Where it was, but they forgot what they were helping that flame. Yeah, stuck on the ridge and I'm fucked the wrong way. Only one real one, yeah, one, yeah. Shit out of me, straight spit, I'm a freak, he's lit. Now flame to your brain, blood burns. What, running back, blood, like, run up this to the death, dead grandma's knees is falling out. What you know about bubbling? Hustle bones coming out my mouth. 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 Coming out my mouth. Hustle bones coming out my. Hustle bones coming out my mouth. Hustle bones coming out my. Spin a knife, pull your life back, spin the wheel, criminal. Well, that was the song. That was Hustle Bones by Death Grips from their 2012 album The Money Store. And I think that's the most recent track that I've listened to doing this show. Yeah, I can see how I missed this one. The other stuff I've reacted to and reviewed on this program was, you know, I was like sort of had that feeling of like Squidward when he eats a Krabby Patty for the first time. How did I go this long without experiencing this? And This song feels like, yeah, like doing, like eating a something bad for the first time. Or there's a better way to put it, bro. I don't know. I don't know how to feel about this because it's like I can tell that this is the yeah, musically. This was very well produced, and it's definitely beyond me how they, you know, how anyone comes up with music, but it's like everything fit, everything works together in the song. I do especially like the part where it's the in the stereo, the kind of back and forth where it's like, I like that sound. I definitely like Zach Hill on the drums. This is a difficult one for me to wrap my head around because it's like I don't want to be cynical, and I don't want to just be negative, but like, you know, like I said earlier, this reminds me of the sort of a delirium that's induced when you take a big handful of Benadryl, the active ingredient in which is diphenhydramine, and in low doses it can, you know, stop your allergies and make you a little drowsy, and then in high doses it can make your heart flutter and beat weird, and then cause you to see spiders and centipedes on the wall, and then sometimes the Hat Man. This feels like music that was produced by the Hat Man after you take 800 milligrams of diphenhydramine. That's what this is like. This feels like, you know, either the sonic equivalent to like a big handful of Benadryl, or drinking an entire bottle of Robitussin, or a bottle of dextromethorphan, which is the active ingredient in NyQuil, or possibly even mixing some of those things together, counterflipping as it's called on the internet. That's what this sounds like. And don't get me wrong, I've certainly counterflipped a few times in my life, and that's always been whether it's mixing a bottle of Benadryl or mixing a bottle of NyQuil with a handful of Benadryl or listening to this song, there's good and bad things about it. And as a whole, it's the experience is kind of it's just the experience itself is what you're hoping to achieve. Whether it's good or bad, it's just to feel something. And I suppose this song fulfills that desire to feel something. This isn't presenting you with anything you thought you wanted to hear. This is a wholly new, at least from my perspective, this is a wholly new experience for me musically, one that fills me with a sense of dread and uneasiness, but that also leaves me very curious as to how anyone could come up with something like this, what this is, who these people are. And I know a little bit about Zach Hill, just having listened to his work with other bands, like Hella or Omar Rodriguez Lopez. I think he did some drumming for the group Bygones. He's been everywhere, but I'm not familiar at all with this MC Ride fellow. And speaking of which, I've said this before, I'm not like a lyrics guy. I don't necessarily care too much about lyrics when it comes to music, as long as everything fits together and sounds nice. And like, I definitely could not understand a single word he said in this song. I think at one point I was able to make out the line, "My steez is balling out." And if I'm not mistaken, I think steez is like a skateboarding term. It's sort of a slang for style. And so if I were to make an attempt to interpret that one snippet I was able to hear, my steez is balling out. I believe referring to a proficiency in basketball, but also having lots of material wealth and flaunting it. I think he's saying his style is balling out. So his style, the way he presents himself to the world, is that in which he showcases his material wealth and money. And, I guess that's fitting. The album is called The Money Store. That's my only guess at what that line means. My steez is balling out. And then the sort of chorus, hustle bone, I was able to hear that, and I think he's saying hustle bones coming out my mouth. I couldn't begin to guess what that means. And it's not like it's a necessity for any like lyrics to ever even make sense. Like, for example, I'm a big fan of the Melvins, and they have like lyrics that are absolute nonsense. They're like Dadaist, like abstract, just sounds. Same with another guy like is Mike Patton, from Faith No More, Mr. Bungle, and Phantomus, which is his sort of super group with the Melvins. He's another guy that just makes sounds that sound good for whatever the song is. So I understand that sort of philosophy when it comes to music. I'm just saying that, like, what I've noticed sort of discovering hip-hop music I've never heard before doing this show, there's definitely an emphasis placed on lyrical composition in hip-hop music. And it's interesting to hear a song where the lyrics seem to have that sort of like Dadaist quality. But that I'm also speaking from a place of not even really understanding most of what was being said by this MC Ride guy. O overall, I like I said, I don't want to be cynical. I don't want to be negative, and I don't want to say that I hated this. It just was a full frontal assault on every sense and sensibility that I have. This like it this felt like I was getting run over and backed over and run over again. And it definitely scared me. It struck fear into my heart listening to this song. But you know, it's that's not to say that I hated it. Like I said, I mean, I love Zach Hill. I'm like really surprised that he's in this group. This group like that I've never even heard of. So I definitely am gonna like I want to check out more of their music. But I gotta, you know, I gotta brace myself. I need to maybe take a Xanax or something before I try to listen to this band's music again. But yeah, I mean, overall, and you know, the thing with all art and music is like the people that push any art form forward are the people who take risks, take chances, and create things that maybe don't even. That don't necessarily make you feel good or happy in a way. It's the things that sort of that make you like question your own sanity sometimes, you know, like looking at a like a Twombly painting with all the scribbles all over it and wondering how does this cost millions of dollars? This is driving me crazy looking at this. So that's sort of. Yeah, that's sort of what Death Grip sounds like to me. The audio equivalent of like a Twombly or a Jackson Pollock painting, you know, just madness scrawled across the canvas. And in this case, you know, madness pressed onto the wax, as it were. anyway, that was Hustle Bones by Death Grips from their 2012 album The Money Store. Death Grips is composed. Leave a comment, let me know what the right word is when trying to say what I'm saying right now. The band is composed or comprised of MC Ride and the drummer Zach Hill, of whom I am very fond, and I am looking forward to and also nervous to listen to more music from this group. But anyway, this has been. Should I try doing like numbered reviews or just do react? I don't like giving stars or this many out of 10. I just sort of like feeling the song and, you know, thinking out loud as I listen to it and talk about it. You know, I don't want to assign any sort of number or star or the you know this many headphones, you know, to the song. These you know just how I feel about it. Just yeah, like I said, the best descriptor I have for this is it's sort of the audio equivalent of robo tripping and taking a bunch of Benadryl and laying in bed while your legs twitch and you see the Hat Man in the corner of the room smiling at you with his big red eyes. Thank you. Please subscribe to the Patreon.com/cornfedwithdaltonpruitt. Rate, review, subscribe this channel, spread the word. Thank you for tuning in. This has been another episode, another edition of Caucasian Critic. It's been me, your boy, the titular Caucasian Critic, the corn-fed white boy, the Daniel Plainview of podcasting, the first billionaire podcaster, White Sonat, your boy, Dalton Pruitt. Thank you, and I love you.